Hey boys, it's Purdue here, and we are back with another Madden 21 video. But today is a little different than what we normally do. I'm going to show you guys a little tips and tricks, kind of Tuesday video, we'll call it. And I'm going to show you guys not one, but two cover three beaters I use in my games. You guys have probably seen me use them before, but I'm going to release them to you guys. I don't know if they're in any other playbooks because I haven't really looked around, but they're in the Baltimore Ravens playbook. That's the playbook I run. If you guys want me to drop like a full scheme or on different formations I run, I'd be willing to do like a full like hour long video going over my offense, all different formations if you guys want it. Or we can break into a series where I can do one formation at a time or a couple, and we can go through each play, why I run them, what defense to run them against, and I think it'll work really well. But for today, we're just going to start off by showing you guys two cover three beaters that absolutely toast cover three. So the first one, again, we're in Baltimore Ravens playbook, but we're in the deuce close. It's one of my favorite formations, and the play we're going to be running is mesh spot. So here, we're going to call a basic like cover three and a 3-4 defense. So we're going to see the play yard here. You want to run this play, well, not even want to, you have to run this play to the Y side of the field. So you need to be on a hash. So we're on the right hash here, and we're on the 25-yard line as if we were just starting our drive from a kickoff. And the only adjustment you want to make, it's pretty simple. You want to put your tight end on an out route, like with triangle is your tight end boil. And then you're going to hit triangle. It's going to bring up all your buttons. You're going to hit triangle again. And then the left joystick to the left is going to put them on an out route. You're going to see them on an out route now. Okay. Now what you're going to do is you're going to hit triangle again. And it's going to bring up this menu. You're going to hit R1. Now what that's going to do is going to put them at the stick. So you only want to run this play is if you're at like first and 10 or a shorter distance. If you're anything longer, it won't work because the route takes too long to develop. You need to be like a short little out route, but play it to the sticks like that. And what it's going to do is this corner on the left side over Marquise Brown here, he's going to get distracted by Nick Boyle for some reason. And with someone like Lamar Jackson, you're going to be able to escape the pocket and really throw this route with the pass lead. Like Michael Vick left-handed, I absolutely love throwing this route to this side of the field. But if you have a pocket passer with someone who is like pass lead elite or something like that who can really pass lead the ball well, you'll be able to lead it away from the safety anyways. You guys will see. And again, a faster receiver like Marquise Brown, or if you guys have Tyreek Hill, there's so many now in Mutt, works really well. So the play works really well like this alone. So I'll show you guys it like this. What I usually like to do though, so actually what I'm going to show you guys is I'm going to block the running back too. And what I usually like is to motion him over. So we're going to begin it like that. I'm just going to show you guys the play like this. So we're going to drop back and you're going to see, look at Square get wide open over the top there. Now again, Lamar Jackson doesn't have the greatest arm, but if you have someone who's a little bit stronger like Michael Vick and that, it'll get a lot more open. If you're able to roll out, it'll get you even better pass lead and everything. So I'm going to try and do that. Now another thing I like to do, so again, we're going to motion over, block our running back, right? So let's bring it up. It's R1 and then R2 to block him. And then you're going to see, we're going to put our tight end on the out route again. Now, again, we have to put him at the sticks, but what I like to do to set up blocking, let's say this outside linebacker on our left is rushing. We want to be able to roll out. So we're going to bring up L1 to mess with our pass adjustments. We're going to go down on the right stick for double team. It's going to bring up this red pointer. So it's going to see D2 for double team. We're going to double team this little D end right here. Then we're going to slide right with our line. So again, left L1 for the offensive line adjustments, and then you're going to right stick to the right for slide right, and then finally you're going to go L1 and X for ID the mic, and you're going to put it right over the left outside linebacker here. So that way your left tackle and your left guard are going to double team that DN, but your running back will pick up that outside linebacker and hopefully should get a chop block animation, making it easier for you to get out. So here he actually drops into coverage, so we're going to roll out easily. And here you're going to see with that rollout, now we have a much better pass with Lamar, and that's going to be a touchdown every time, guys. Now again, if it doesn't get open, it's because your opponent is smart and they're pointing out deep paths. If you guys didn't know, deep paths will nullify any cover three beater. If you put the corners in deep paths, no matter what cover three beater you run, it will not get open. Deep halves play different. This is for when they have the outside thirds on. So you guys will see on defense here, these are outside thirds. If I were to put this corner in a deep half like this, you'll see the zone is different on the left. We'll run the play again, and you guys are going to see it will not get open. So here, we're going to even move everyone over. And you can see I make the adjustments pretty quick when I want to. But you're going to see, no matter what, this corner will just not stay with it. And even if I throw this route, you know, it's not there. Like, it's bagged. That's it. So it's a deep half that'll take it away. But you guys, that's what will beat it. So now I'm going to show you guys the second formation that really has a really good cover three beater I like to run. And again, Baltimore Ravens playbook, we're still in. And this is that first play was the second formation in gun, D's close. This next one is going to be the fifth formation, flex Y off. I believe it's in other playbooks. I've seen other people run it. And I know I've seen this play in other playbooks, but it's double post is the play. And we're going to call that. And again, it's never cover three beaters. So we're just going to come on a basic cover three. And again, you want to run this one to the tight side of the field. So the other one's to the wide side of the field. This one's to the tight. So it's a good way to attack your opponent both ways. And there's other good plays out of these formations. So again, I can do full-on videos on these formations. If you guys want to see breakdowns of these formations and how I run them and what plays to run in your audibles, I can go over that. I'm happy to do that. But here, this is the play right here. And ideally, we're going to hit Snead on this post route over the middle onto the right side for cover three. So what we're going to do, we're going to bring up our receivers. And just like we were putting our tight end on an out route to the sticks last time, we're going to do it with our receiver circle. So we're going to put circle on an out route, Marquise Brown, and we're going to put him to the stick. So now it's going to look like that. And that's going to pull down Stephon Gilmore, the corner. It's going to pull him down so that way he's going to get distracted by the out route and Snead will get open over the top. Now, what I like to do is streak the running backs. That way, by the time the post route gets over, he's going to distract the safety into playing his middle third zone. I also like to put Andrews on a delay fade, and then I can double team the outside linebacker to the right, who I can see, since it's a 3-4, since he's the one on the line there, and the other one, and the left outside linebacker is away, I can see which one is rushing. I know it's the guy to the right, so I want him double team people, get out of the pocket, especially since Lamar's right-handed. This is going to be a much easier throw for him. So delay fade the tight end is going to be a really good way. He's going to block until you release him. And personally, I also like to motion Boykin here for the drag. So here again, we're going to do the double team just like we went over last time. So to do the double team, it's left stick down, and then we're going to move it over to outside linebacker and double team him there. And again, for the drags, it's triangle, square, and down. So I want to make sure our double team is still there. It is. So this is the play art right here, guys. This is what it's going to look like. And you're going to see we're going to go out. Hopefully we get the time in the pocket. It looks like we are, and you're going to see it's butt naked open, and boom, Snead gets wide open, and you guys will take that for a touchdown. Again, faster receivers, better quarterbacks. You don't even need to roll out. You will be able to make that throw from the pocket, I promise you. I'm going to try to see if we can do it from the pocket with Lamar. It's going to be harder since he's not really a pocket passer. He may not get the lead I like, but we're going to try it anyways just to try and show you guys that it does, in fact, work. So here, we want to try and motion snap this square, too, so that way you can get all your adjustments off. So boom, it'll look like this. We're going to try and stay in the pocket. Hopefully get the time. Okay, it's wide open, but we didn't get the time there, unfortunately. It does get open. You guys can make that throw, but that's why I also like to roll out with these plays, because having a mobile quarterback allows you to do that. I'm going to try it one more time. You're even going to see Stephon Gilmore have his X factor. It won't make a difference. Like, this play still gets open. I'm just going to see if we can do it from the pocket. So if you guys have like a Dan Marino, Derek Carr, even Brett Favre is another big one that you guys may have. Okay, here we're kind of able to get off. Again, the safety is able to play that ball because, again, we don't have great pass lead with Lamar and we're under pressure there. But if you guys do have like a good pass lead quarterback, that will get open. But I always like running this better with mobile quarterbacks. So those are the two cover three beaters I wanted to share with you guys. It's really good. I think it'll be really lethal if you guys execute them well. And again, it's out of the Baltimore Ravens playbook and gun deuce close, and it's flex Y off and gun. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you guys use the plays in your next gameplay. And honestly, guys, if you want to see full breakdowns on the scheme, I run so many of these different formations. Like, honestly, every single one of these gun formations, sorry, I can go through them all, and I know how to run pretty much every single one of these formations. I can run plays out of. A lot of times I don't, because obviously there's ones I prefer better than the other, but I could go through probably about 6 different formations in gun alone, and pistol I actually probably can run out of almost every pistol formations here. It's really good. I can help you guys with who you want put in your scheme. I can really do a full ebook for you guys, and I think it'd be a really good way to help boost the channel. But that's what I wanted to give you guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please use those plays in your weekend league gameplay. And let me know how you guys do and how you guys like them. And I'll see you guys next time. But leave a like down below.